Reactivity of pyridine. In this video, we are going to discuss the reactivity of pyridine. That means which reactions are given by the pyridine, either nucleophilic substitution reaction or electrophilic substitution reaction, and where, at which position nucleophilic substitution reactions are taking place, and at which places electrophilic substitution reactions are taking place, that we are going to discuss. As usual, first of all, you consider the resonance or resonance structures for the pyridine. Now, this is the pyridine where actually pi bond is taken by the nitrogen, which is electronegative, more electronegative, and because of minus I effect, this can take this pair on the nitrogen. So if I remove this pair on the nitrogen, it is already having one lone pair. One extra pair is coming from this bond. And you can see here at this carbon, there are just three electrons. If there are three electrons, it will generate a positive charge. So the cation is formed here at this carbon. And nitrogen having now six electrons, two, four, and one from this bond, one from this bond. Actually, we need five electrons on the nitrogen for the neutral nitrogen. And if one electron extra, we put negative charge, and one electron less, we put positive charge. So here, six electrons around this nitrogen. Because of this, this negative charge is developed. Now, once this carbocation is developed, you can shift adjacent pi bond from this two carbon to here, so if you move this bond here from this carbon to here, the similar structure will develop here at this carbon. So the positive charge is obviously migrated from this carbon to this carbon. Now you can draw one more resonance by shifting adjacent pi bond here in between these two carbons from here to here. So I have shifted here. Now the similar structure is developed here at this carbon. So the positive charge is delocalized from this carbon to this carbon. In this way, you can draw three structures where the charge distribution is possible, and one more structure which is not having any charge separation. Now from these 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 structures, you can draw its hybrid, which is called resonance hybrid. So this is a resonance hybrid where the double bond is actually moving in all atoms, on all atoms. So because of this, I have drawn a dotted line, because no bond is a complete double bond and no bond is a complete single bond. So the bond is lying between double and single bond. So that's why we have to represent by using a dotted line in the resonance hybrid. Here, at this carbon, you can see the positive charge, but in the next structure, there is no positive charge. At this carbon, there is no positive charge, but in the next structure, there is positive charge. At this carbon, there is no positive charge, but in the next structure, there is positive charge. So, this positive charge is not a complete positive charge, but it is partial positive charge. In fact, at each carbon, there is just plus 1/3 positive charge. There is not that charge is not complete one positive charge. So because of that, you have to show a partial positive charge at position number, you can see 2, 4 and 6. Now the further explanation you can provide by using this resonance hybrid. You watch that resonance hybrid carefully and decide, first of all, provide explanation for nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is identity of nucleophilic substitution reaction? It's having sufficient electron or more electrons. So obviously, this nucleophile will attack here, and will go here, because at carbon number 2, 4 and 6, this is carbon number 2, this is carbon number 4, and this is carbon number 6, there is less electron density because of positive charge. So nucleophile having sufficient electron, and at 2, 4, 6 position, there is less electron density. Obviously, nucleophile is having chance to get attack here. So from this observation we can draw one conclusion that in pyridine nucleophilic substitution taking place at carbon number 2, 4 and 6. Now we'll move toward the electrophilic substitution reactions. Electrophile is an electron deficient species. So obviously this electrophile will not go at carbon number 2, 4 and 6 because these are electron deficient sites. As compared to this, if you see here, site number 3 and site number 5, there is no positive charge. That means as compared to these three sites, these are electron rich sites. So obviously electrophile will go there at carbon number 3 and 5. So from this observation we can draw the conclusion that electrophilic substitution takes place either at position number 3 and 5. So this is by using this simple resonance structures we can provide explanation for nucleophilic substitution reaction as well as electrophilic substitution reaction. One more point I have written here, that the electrophilic substitution reactions are actually common reactions for aromatic compounds and pyridine is aromatic, but electrophilic substitution reaction is difficult. Why it is difficult? Because of this nitrogen heteroatom. So nitrogen is electron deficient, I mean this is electron negative, and because of minus I effect this is actually withdrawing all electron density towards itself. So these positions are actually becoming electron deficient. If they are electron deficient, how that electrophile can go and attack there? So this is not possible, which is not observed in case of benzene. So as compared to benzene, electrophilic substitution reactions are difficult in case of pyridine. One more point I have written here, nucleophilic substitution in pyridines are relatively easier. I mean, you can compare with other aromatic compounds like benzene, where the nucleophilic substitution reactions are not possible, or they are possible under drastic conditions, because there is repulsion between nucleophile and the circulating cloud. But because of this heteroatom nitrogen, which is removing electron density due to minus I effect, that is negative inductive effect, and making positions electron deficient little bit as compared to other aromatic centers. So because of this, nucleophilic substitution reactions are bit relatively easier as compared to other aromatic rings. So in this way, you can provide explanation for the reactivity of pyridine. Thank you.